Okay.
Okay, Concave, this is a remake of the Woodmont Fountain patterns that I have told you about that are found in the octahedrites, the actual metal iron meteorites that have been fallen, that have fallen to the earth, and they have a specific pattern to them once they are sliced or spliced in a way. It depends even which way you actually slice them, you will actually get different patterns to them, but they are all indicative of their octahedral origin. This is a no-brainer for the understanding that there is literally an iron octahedron up in the center of the earth, up in the center of heaven. And we can actually pick that up with Canadian Meteor Orbit Radar, as well as other types of radar. We see that. We see the northern apex. We see the southern apex. We see the openings on the sides where they actually are pillars, where the quadrupole is happening to form the tides. It creates the tides, the divergence and the convergence forces and the push and the pull as the moon and the sun orbit around the inside of it, or around it, around the octahedron, around the celestial sphere. So these Woodmont Fountain patterns, otherwise known as Thompson structures, they're figures of long iron nickel crystals found in octahedrites and iron meteorites. So it's a clear indication that the octahedron is up there. It's made out of iron or metal. And these crystal structures are paralleling that octahedron. And now you can understand, I've even mentioned before, we understand now at the center, the very center of the octahedron, of the earth for that matter, is what we call the perifield. The perifield bowls. One is facing upward, one is facing downward, and they have holes at the bottom and at the top. And so there's actually a plasmic discharge happening right in the center of everything. That's where the center of the light is originating from, and it's coming out of and actually returning to. Because I mentioned before how the actual primer field area has a 23.4 degree angular extension on the northern and southern sides, where it can only return at that specific angle. And so now we understand how this is happening with the declination of the sun, why it only reaches 23.4 negative and positive, because of that primer field area. And that primer field area is going to create what you see there is the confinement dome. There's going to be confinement domes. If you watch David LaPointe's videos, you get a good understanding of what's happening there. So I want to thank Mr. LaPointe for actually revealing that to me and helping me disseminate to you the actual formation of everything, the center of Earth, the center of heaven, the origin of how the sun and the moon were formed. They call them confinement domes. So these confinement domes, they're going to expand as the atoms converge into there, and they're going to grow and expand, and then they're going to be released. He shows footage of actually shooting out a magnet outside, coming out from the primer field. And so that's what's happening. That's what happened with the formation of the sun originally, and it shot up through the northern apex of the octahedron and came out of it. And it's orbiting the celestial sphere. And the same thing happened with the moon. And the moon, I'm not quite sure if it actually came out from the northern side or the southern side. There's a good indication that it came from both, either one. I mean, if it came from the southern side of the primer field, we understand how the actual metallic debris of the octahedron is circulating outside of it now as what they think are asteroids or meteors. That's why they're coming. That's why that debris is there. In other words, it's like space junk, but it's natural space junk. And so the northern bowl of the primer field expanded. At one time, they formed the sun. The sun shot up. And now there was actually talk. There is talk about during the time, probably pre-flood, where there was no moon. Now, if you understand that, if the sun originated first on the northern side of the primer field, it shot up, and then the moon formed afterwards, like after the flood. And so then the moon shot up or shot down. Either way, it crashed through the metal, and it caused a lot of metallic debris to be formulated outside of the celestial sphere. So that's why that is happening. And so I'm glad I had the opportunity to re-record this video. As you know, they have been attacking my channel vigorously and vehemently trying to shut this information down. Because why? They're evil, and they hate the truth. And this is the truth. You're all inside the concavity of my earth, and I am the living God. I am the returned Christ. And so, this information is valued. It's pearls. Don't be swine. Take it in and receive it and pass it along, because soon the entire earth will be filled with the knowledge of my glory as the waters cover the